day, friends, and welcome back to another awesome Tinkercad lesson. This is one of my all-time favorites. It is the keychain lesson. So let's start a brand new design, and let me show you what I need you to do if you want to print a keychain in my class. Step one is always to name it. So I'm going to put keychain, and I'm going to put MDH after it, and because I've made many of these, I'm going to call it keychain 2018. When you've got your keychain done, you need to decide what you're going to make it of. I choose rectangles most often, but cylinders are cool too. There are other items down here that you can pick also, like the hearts and the stars. When you pick one, I tell you that it has to be 70, and I'm going to tell you that it needs to be 25 in depth. I make mine 2 millimeters thick. I want yours 2 millimeters thick as well. So by simply doing that, you have got what we call the keychain base that we're going to build on. One nice thing you can do is take your radius and change it to 2. And when you press enter, notice that rounds your keychain so it won't have any sharp corners. You can change the steps to whatever you want. If you do 2, you can see it just bevels the edges, which is kind of cool. I'm going to hit the fit view to selection so you can see a little more of what it looks like. And these are numbers that you can adjust as you try and make your keychain look the way you want. Let's see what happens if I do 4. That works too. Looks more like a surfboard. I'm going to go back to 2 and I'm going to leave it like that. Let's bring out a cylinder so we can make a hole for our keychain. I'm going to do the fit view so it zooms in on that little piece. And then I'm going to grab one corner and I'm going to hold shift and I'm going to shrink it till it's 5 millimeters on a side. When you've got it lined up, I'm going to zoom back out, so I just rolled my wheel, and I'm going to do a couple arrow keys, and I'm going to look at it from the top. When I've got it in that corner where I want it, I'm going to simply grab both pieces, so I'm just drawing a rectangle that touches both, and I'm going to group them. So now my keychain has got a cool place to put the little keychain part. The next step is to add our words, and I want to add my words right to the top of this. So I'm going to press W for work plane, or you can click work plane, and I'm going to set my words right there. I could use this text, but I want to use the awesome all text that is in under script. When you bring out script, notice it drops right on top. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make it 1.5 millimeters thick. That is the number that I like you to have. And then you can pick whichever font you want to use. I'm actually going to choose the script one. And then I'm going to put my name on the keychain. You can put whatever you want on your keychain as long as it's school appropriate. When I adjust it with the black handle so that it only moves in one direction at a time. I use my arrow keys to nudge it into place. And once again, I take a look at it from the top to make sure that it's just the way I want it. You can see here that I was bumping into the hole, so I'm going to just go over a little and then I'm going to stretch it, all the time using the black handles in the middle instead of the white handles. When I've got my keychain just the way I want it, I am going to grab the two of them and I'm going to group them. I'm going to take a look at them from the front to make sure that I dropped it right on the keychain so it's attached. And right there, you will have created your own keychain. If you want to print it, the next step is to click export and choose STL. And you should have set your settings a while ago to ask where to save. And when it does ask, you want to choose desktop, MT tools, and then the magic STL folder. And then it is ready to be saved so it can be printed. Alright, so I didn't give you instructions, but you can see some of the creative things I did using different shapes. You can see here I used scribble, which you could make scribble for all your words. Just remember to follow the rules where it's 70 by 25 for whatever shape you make, unless it's one of these shapes where you can see I went 1, 2, 3, 4, so about 40 by 40 for a shape like that. And then the same trick, you would click on the one you were interested in printing. You cannot do multicolor, just so you know. You can make them look pretty on your screen, but they will be one color when we print. And it would be the same technique where you click one, you hit export, you do the STL, and it'll already know it's the STL folders, and it'll put 02 after it because you're only exporting one piece. You're not exporting them all. So there you go, friends. Many awesome keychains you can make. One of my favorite lessons all time. If you liked it, please hit that like button. Friends, if you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. And if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HLModTech, hit that notification bell. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.